Welcome everybody to this tutorial. Today we're talking about the fastest way to edit photos in Rawtherapee. Now, when I'm talking about fast, I'm not talking about good. I'm talking about automating the process so that you can get everything 80 to 90% there, and then from that point go on to tweak little things. So this would be if you, let's say you took 1,000 photos and you just wanted to send something to a client and you basically didn't want to send just the raw files. So I have a couple photos here. These I took a long time ago, and the first thing that you're going to do is just go ahead and come over to your batch edit and just select everything. Now I would suggest that you only select based on lens. So if you use different lenses, then I would go ahead and let's see here in the filter sections, you could come down here and select based on lens and there's other pictures that I don't have shown here. So if you selected the... Yeah, so you can see if I select my telephoto lens, I don't have any of those pictures that are five-starred. But I have my 18-55, and so the first thing that you're going to do is select by lens, and then over here in the Batch X Edit, go ahead and hit Control-A. And then come over and apply your lens corrections. And then just head back to your filter and select your other lenses, and then go back and apply those lens corrections. Once you do that, that's step one. Once you do that, then you are good to go. You just go ahead and turn off your filters so you have everything selected, and then hit Control A to select everything, and then head over here to your batch edit. Next, just go ahead and click auto levels, and that will automatically change the exposure, the highlight and shadow compensation for all of your photos. And then you can just come over here to sharpening and turn that on. For me personally, I like to take the amount of sharpening and put it up to, not 4,000, 400. And then just turn on your local contrast, leave it that. All where it is, and come down to noise correction or noise reduction. For me, I always like to add just a little bit of noise reduction because my camera isn't the best. You may feel like adding noise reduction is not what you want, but regardless, I like to add a little bit. And then you can come over here to color, and you go to vibrance and turn that on. And I like to stick vibrance somewhere around 20 and turn on protect skin tones. And then the last thing is soft light. Okay, so the only other thing that I would say is here in saturation, put that up to 20 as well. So now if I go ahead and double click on this photo, you can see what we've got. Let me go ahead and say reset to default. This is what we had, and then if I hit Control Z, this is what we ended up with without doing anything to this photo. Now, when we hit auto levels, things like the highlight compression generally gets applied pretty heavily. So if I go ahead and pull that back, you can see what happens. We lose out a lot on the sky and things like that. And then you might feel like, hey, this photo is a little bit too dark. You might feel like it's a little bit too light. You might feel like you need to add in some contrast with curves here. Maybe something a little bit more like that, I feel like is a better looking photo. But here's the thing. I've gone ahead and edited all my photos that I took. So actually that day that I took these photos, I think I took something like 300 photos. So I've gone ahead and edited all of those photos, and then I can just go through and I can just mess with the tone curve a little bit. I know that my colors are generally right. I know that my white balance is generally where I want it to be. And the process was basically completely automated. So for me, this is what I do. And I'll just run through that again. You just go ahead and click auto levels. You turn on some sharpening, turn on some local contrast and some noise reduction if you feel like it. And then you turn on your vibrance and your soft light. So if you just go through, select all your photos, and add all of that in, you are good to go. Anyway, this is a short little video, and I hope it's helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching.